What a beautiful day to be doing some archaeology and get that Imkando Madoc. Welcome to another Iron Man episode. I hope you guys will enjoy this one. We're going to start off by actually getting that last Madoc piece and then hunting for the Dragon Madoc through Big Game Hunter, which is actually going to be the first time I've ever done it, but it doesn't seem too complicated, so it shouldn't be that bad. And hopefully I can get lucky with getting both the Madoc piece and the Dragon Madoc when I need it. But link to my Discord is always at the top of the description. Gotta say that before I start the video. Also, if you do like the video, please leave a like. I'll say it now in the beginning so I don't have to say it in the end. But hope you guys will enjoy the episode. Let's see if we can get this. There it is. That actually did take some time, but that is the last piece of the Imkando metal that I needed. So now I have to go to a Big Game Hunter and get that Dragon Madoc. So I just finished my first Big Game Hunt and I got this. The thing that you put in your player owned farm, which is actually a 1 in 65 drop rate. So that was kind of lucky. I didn't get the Dragon Madoc on the first one, but that is definitely a pretty good outcome. What is it actually? Is it a male or something? Oh, 98 to check this animal. So I have a bit left to go, but going to put that into the bank at least. And this is some stuff to make, some hunting stuff I assume. And this is like the best melee weapon in the game versus ranged creatures, I think. But yeah, this is, you need 2,000 of these and these are the rare items. Oh, I got it. I got the Dragon Madoc. Oh my god, fine. Okay, that was so spoon fed. What is it called? A Big Game. I have done 14. Oh my god, that looks so good. I can actually make the Imkando one now. Now, this is what I have to do after I have all these items. By the way, look at the price of this. 20 mil for the Dragon Madoc. But you need to have a Red Berry Pie, 1 million in your inventory. And then I guess I talk to him to help me make a Madoc. And then you have to give him 1 million and a Red Berry Pie. So I had to make that. And I have 1.7 million here. So it drains that 1 million, and now I assume I have to go to that forge that I unlocked in, I think, my last video, and make this Dragon Madoc with all these pieces. This is going to be so nice. I brought my augmenter as well, so I can augment it right away. I don't know really what this is. Seed of the Charyu tree, I guess we will look in a bit, but construct the Madoc. And from now on, I will be able to get invention experience for this, and by the way, this is actually a level 80 Madoc, but it acts like a tier 90. So it is going to be faster archaeology experience until level 90. After that, it is nothing too special. But let's augment this Madoc, and we also have to get some perks on this. I will have to look into what perks I want on this. But let's actually see what this is first off. I'm not sure what this is. It's really cold, colder than stone cold. Maybe it is a magic preserver somehow. I guess I'll Google it. Also, if you have fire gloves from a minigame or quest, whatever, you can make this into an active one, and it is just a relic that you unlock that makes it so when you cut trees, the logs get burned instantly for fire-making experience. I think these are the best I can do without Ancient Invention. Got a Honed 4, you can pause and read it if you want to see what it does. And then the second one I'm going to go with is Imp's Old 4. So I'm just going to apply both of these to the Imkando Madoc. And we should be good to go. I'm pretty sure this is bugged. I'm trying to become the associate rank and this says no requirements. Like if I press the professor one, there is all these requirements I have to do. But for the associate one, there is none. And I think I still had the, like, I had like 180 out of 250 restored artifacts. But that one just disappeared when I completed the find 250 artifacts. But I can't actually get ranked up anyway, so I guess this is just bugged and doesn't actually show all the things. Man, I actually really want that archaeology outfit, so I'm probably going to try to get this number 166 restorations completed to 250. And that's going to take a while, but I think a good thing to do is I just should go for completing logs here. Because I need these chrononauts anyways to buy the outfit later. I think it's like 50k for the full set. And I can just easily go and get these low level ones. And this one is already completed, but I can get these. And that should be a good way to get fast restorations and the chrononauts. Got some more restored ones at 183 right now. And I have a lot of chrononauts to get here in my inventory. full completed Sarosian 1 log. And then I think I completed the Samurakian 2 as well. Yep, got quite a lot of chrono notes for that one. And I think this one as well. So we're getting a lot of completed logs now, which is actually very good for qualifications as well. And I think on Bandos I had like one thing. And then this one is probably on Saradomin on the second one. No, I'm not sure actually where this one is. Maybe it's the Saradomin 3. Yeah, it actually is. So it's a very high one, Saradomin 3. But yeah, 22,000 chrono notes. How much is this actually in the main game? Because 170 each. So that is like a few mil at least, I think. So as I need to restore like 65 more artifacts, I think the best way of actually doing it, I might be wrong, but I feel like it's the best thing to do, is just go to like a level 5 thing. This one is, I think, for level 5, yeah. And I get these artifacts really, really fast, and then I'll just restore a bunch of them, really low level, not really care about the experience, just to get that outfit and the rank. I actually got all the artifacts I need in the bank, but I also got a Tetra Compass, and I need a lot of Sarosian Insignias and Third Age Iron right now to be able to restore all those artifacts. So I'm going to power this up real quick, and we're going to complete another Tetra Compass, and hopefully get either Sarosian Insignia or Third Age Iron. Here we go, we also have the 1 in 10,000 chance of getting the Tony's Madoc, of course, or the shadowy key that unlocks it. But let's see what we get. We get... do we get any... Oh, Sarosian Insignia! Perfect, that's exactly what I wanted. And some buffs. Oh my god, that's 50,000 archaeology experience right there. And we also got 50 Onyx Dust. This was a really nice one. Dragonkin Staff is a really high level one, so I don't think I can do that. I'm just going to take it out. And then bank the rest. 3.6 million. That's kind of insane. I think this is like 90 or 100. Yeah, 99. Yeah, that I can't really use that quite yet, but 50,000 experience here is like half of what I need to 85. This is so strange. I got over 250 restorations, but nothing popped up. I didn't get an achievement or anything. But if I go into my qualifications, it actually says that I should be able to get a rank up because I don't see it anywhere. The next ones is Professor and Guildmaster. So I assume it's just done. So if I just go here... And then it says, oh, so I can actually just do it. So it was just bugged. It didn't pop up an achievement or anything. So now I'm going to rank up and I will be able to buy the outfit. Nice, very nice. Associate rank and some other stuff unlocked like titles. And I can do more research teams, which is very nice. Casual experience. But the most important thing is buying the outfit. So let's go and buy it for 6% more archaeology experience. By the way, during this, I did actually get to 85. But let's just buy the full outfit. I've been a bit behind on this. I should have had it a bit earlier, but because I did so much Tears of Gothics, I was kind of behind. As you see, 356 chrono notes left, and I will have to get chrono notes for these upgrades as well, but I'm going to get that meanwhile just leveling now. These are actually the last porters I have, but for this level 85, I'm actually not going to get more porters because the cart is fairly close and I only have to do one single level. But after 85, when I get to 86, I have to get to 89 from 86 in Karadet. And the area where I have to do it is really annoying to not have porters at. So I'm actually going to, at 86, go and collect quite a lot of porters through divination, as I can make a lot of dragonstone necklaces to make the highest tier porters that are 50 charges. And I'm going to use porters on the future areas. I'm actually just doing a Reaper assignment. By the way, look at my boots. Yeah, that's not the boots I wanted to bring. But I got an Armadale crossbow, and actually after this I can do another Reaper assignment as well. I don't really have any use for this. I guess I could augment it or something and just disassemble it later, but that's pretty much it. And two kills later, a Saradomin Hilt. If this would be old school, that would be insane. I actually don't have this. I don't think I've ever got the Saradomin Hilt. It's 7 mil in the main game. That's another spot for the collection log, I guess. Completed some mysteries and did some archaeology and got 86, so we can now go to the Karadet area and do that all the way to 89. And as I was talking about the porters, I actually made all the porters. I spent all the dragon stones that I had to make the porters. So we now have, I mean, one of these is 50 charges, so this is like 5,000 or 6,000 almost. Charges for the Grace of the Elves necklace porters, so we have a lot of porters to spend now. I'm working on archaeology now in Kaverdet, and I actually just finished an achievement, which is to light up 8 of these shadow anchors, and when you do that, these spawn, the ghost legionnaires, and you talk to them and you get quite a lot of materials, which is super good for Iron Man, and there should be 8 of them at every single shadow anchor, so I'm going to get quite a lot of materials from all of these. There was actually only 4 of them, I don't know why I thought there was 8, but this is all the materials that I got, so pretty decent. The Ancient Vis is very useful for these items that I've collected, because, well, these doesn't require it, but I think it's these that does. Yeah, Ancient Vis, I got 110 now, so that's a decent amount of experience, but you can also enter here, and as you can see in the chat, this is 118 to uncover, and this is 114, so I won't be able to actually use these for a very long time, but for the future it is nice to have that. I'm actually taking a break from archaeology to actually complete a quest, which is Land of the Goblins, and it should be done in just a second here. The reason why I'm actually doing this is because this is the last requirement I have to do for a mystery in the Infernal Source, which is archaeology related, but if I do the Contract Clause, I think it's called, after that I can do a mystery called Dagon Bai, which unlocks the Ancient Summoning, which is going to allow me to use Ripper Demons, which is super strong for PVMing, so I want to get this done as soon as I possibly can, but that is the quest done. I actually have to go to the player-owned farm and do some stuff here. I bought a bunch of cows and bulls because I had a lot of beans, and I actually built the lodge pen twice. I got 2 of them, and I put 3 cows in each, which is the maximum you can have, because for the mystery, you need a specific type of cow, which can take quite a while. You need a chocolate, strawberry, vanilla, or harlequin cow, which is a type of cow that you can get from breeding. So it's kind of RNG if you can actually get it. So I guess meanwhile these are growing and actually I'm trying to get that, I'm just going to go back to farming archaeology. I've actually been wanting to do some Beastmaster Durzag just now and then for that ability codex that I still don't have. And IM Resonance invited me to a group, so hopefully I won't be feeding too much on this boss. I don't have that many kills at all. I can actually go and check real quick here how many I have. I only have 5 kills, so I've done the boss a few times, but only as DPS, and I will probably only keep doing it as DPS, but let's see if we can get a kill and what I'll get. And that is the kill. Super clean, actually. That was such a good group, so thanks to everyone that is here. I'll just click through some names here randomly. And by the way, there is a guy like working construction outside my house, so sorry if there's banging in the background. But let's have a look at what the loot is going to be, and that is not great. I'm going to- wait, you can reroll this? Can you actually? Or I need some items for that, I guess. So I can't do that, but the techie is always super useful, because I already have a decent amount of techie, actually. If I go into the currency pouch, that is not the right one. If I check the currency pouch, and then- is it here? I guess, yeah. So I now have 5,200 techie. And with this, well, with 5,200 techie, you can actually go here and buy raid rewards, and you can buy the gear for techie, but I want to get the abilities. Mask up teleport, okay, I don't want that. The thing I want is these ones, corruption shot, corruption blast, and onslaught ability. I think that's a pretty good one as well. So 15k techie is what I'll need. Oh my goodness, I am so tired right now. I am actually up at 3 in the night, and I've been doing archaeology, like, passively AFK for the past 15 hours. And I did actually use all the pylon batteries that I got on these shadow anchors. That was earlier in the videos. I did spend more than these in these 15 hours. But I have collected 152, and we're going to charge the pylon with that many, and that should get me to 88 by a bit, actually. I think I'll get like maybe 70,000 experience from this. Oh, it's only 49,000. I actually thought it would be more. But yeah, that is still a lot of experience. 88, and only one more level until I can go to another area. So that is very nice. I still have a lot of porter as well, so that shouldn't be a problem. Oh no, they got a Kandarin cow. Just a normal one. I think this is the kid. Wait, is this the kid? Elder? This is, yeah, this is the kid, and it didn't become one of the, like, strawberry, chocolate, or vanilla cows. Unfortunate. I hope that the next time I will get it. I feel like I've been here long enough now, and it feels pretty good to be able to hand in these 188 pylon batteries to actually get 89 archaeology, one step closer to ancient archaeology. Now I can actually go to another area, which is very nice with some change. Hey, look at that! I got a vanilla cow, perfect on the second round, so let's just remove that. And now we actually have, I think we have at least all the things I need to complete the mystery. Oh my god, this was actually harder than I expected. You have to get all the different ones. You have to get the vanilla, strawberry, and the chocolate cow, or the one that is all of them combined together. That is really difficult, actually, for an Iron Man. So I can't actually do the entire mystery. I just have to wait until I can get all of them. So that's going to take quite some time. This is actually going to be the second time I'm siphoning my Incando Mattock. The reason why I'm showing it now is because this is going to be 96 invention. So we're getting a bit closer to being able to get the Essence of Finality. All I really need for that is a Hydrix, which is like, I think, 180 Reaper points away, and I have to get to 100 invention, because I do have an extreme invention potion, which is enough to get all the way to 117, which is the requirement to make it. I'm actually going to mix it up a bit in my archaeology grind. I'm going to start farming some Tetra Compasses, and as you see, I have an ancient casket already, meaning a finished Tetra Compass in the bag. We're going to open that in just a second. But this is how you do it. You basically go here at, I think you need 83 archaeology to be able to finish this whole log. And you just need one of each of these, and you get one Tetra Compass piece. So you need four of each of these to make one full Tetra Compass. And the reason why it's pretty good to actually farm them is because if I open this now, we actually get these completed tomes, and one of these are currently like 24,000 experience for me. So this is almost 50,000 experience, as well as, of course, we can get these damaged artifacts as well as a lot of supplies. So overall, I think it's a very nice experience, also a master clue. But yeah, this is going to be a way to get some experience in a pretty decent way, and a bit different than just grinding out normal archaeology. Pretty big milestone incoming here, should be done now. 90 archaeology. That is 500,000 experience to 91. And I actually have to get all the way to 95. But I can actually use the Orthan dig site now. I wonder if the artifacts there actually have like better experience or something. Probably not, but still pretty nice to get to 90. It does take a while, but I got 3 Tetra Compasses from that, and I still have one piece in the bank as well, but I can't complete that, of course. But that required me to complete, I think it is 12 full entire logs of that, so 12 of each of the components you need, or artifacts. So it does take quite some time to get all the materials on an Iron Man and all the artifacts and everything, but I'm going to power these now, and we're going to complete 3 Tetra Compasses. So every time you open one of these caskets, you can get 1 to 2 of those experience tomes, and hopefully I get 2 in all of them, but hopefully I get like 5 or 6 at least. So somewhere around in the top or the middle of that would be very nice. So let's see what the first one's going to be. First one is 1 tome, and I think none of these are really that useful. I think they're pretty high level, but I got Onyx Dust, which is pretty nice. Let's bank all of that. And I guess I just take that. Let's see if we get 2 this time. 1 again. Ah, that is unlucky, but all of these are very good. Like, temporary increase the base magic precision by 20%. Very nice. I'm not sure what these seeds are actually good for, but that's a bank again. And take out the tome. Hopefully we can get 2 this time. And we do get 2 tomes, very nice. And we get some Alki Balls as well. And it's so random what you get from these. But also some actually useful artifacts that I can repair. I'm not sure if I showed this before, but this is the experience, what it looks like. You just click on this desk here, and 31,000, 31,000, and another 31,000. But I still need like 300,000 experience for 91, so it is quite a grind. And I think that should be enough of Tetra Compass's grind for now, because, well, it took me pretty much a whole day to get those. Something though that was really nice from the grind is I got so many chrononotes. I think I had like 1k before, and I actually have a mission out now for 10k chrononotes as well. That's going to give me like 60,000 experience. But I finished a log here as well in the museum, and I got 10k more, so I have 57,000, and with that I can actually go here and I can buy the auto screener blueprint. So I'm going to do that, and now I can actually, with invention, I'm not sure if I can already do it, but I can actually get something that gives me way more materials. It basically just takes the soil that I get and makes it into materials right away, which is way better than what I have right now, which is all these soils just in my bank. I actually spent a decent amount of time to get this auto-screener because you had to get some really annoying components to be able to actually make it. But now that I have it, oh my god, is it insane. Look at my inventory, not a single soil. It is so nice, I will never have to screen again, and the amount of charge this actually drains is so insignificant. It takes 3.3 per use, and I currently have like, let's see, I have 94 hours of charge in, well, I have 0.45 charge per second, and if you think about it, this one might be taking, I mean, maybe double that of the Mcandle Madoc, so I probably have like 40 hours or something of auto-screener, which is pretty insane for the amount of charge I have. I really don't have that much charge, to be honest, and it is giving me so much material, and I can just deposit it here at the ore then dig site, and one of these ritual bells gives me 10,888 experience, and with the outfit, that is like 11.5k experience, so very nice experience. Also, I do have a lot of compass rows and gold runes already, so this should be a pretty good area to do archaeology. But for now, this is actually going to be the end of this video. I know that this video was pretty much 100% archaeology, and I went from an 83 to 90 and a half in this video, which is 7 levels, which seems maybe low, but it is such a slow skill, it is actually insane. I've been doing archaeology for like 10 hours at least every single day for the past week. So 7 levels for 70 hours, that is like 1 level per 10 hours. That is pretty crazy, but I really, really want to get to that 95 ancient invention unlock, because it is going to give me so many things that I can do, and I already have so many plans for PVMing that is going to be so fun to do. And also on top of that, I just want to get my chocolate and strawberry cow, or the Harlequin cow, because if I get that, I can actually get the Ripper Demons as well, which is an insanely good follower. So if I can just get 95 archaeology, get that done, and we have some insane things for PVMing for the future episodes. But as I said, this will be the end for this video. Hope you guys did enjoy it. If you did, please leave a like, subscribe to the channel if you wanna see when I post these future videos. Have a good one, guys. Take care.